今日咧有一個好好嘅機會，我哋咧被邀請嚟參觀同埋訪問啊、一個二十年喺香港咧做咗好多藝術展覽啊、支持咗好多藝術家嘅一個 gallery， 佢哋咧就叫 Ten Chancery Lane Gallery。20 years anniversary is terrific. The group with 44 artists around the world, including numerous artists like Wang Keping, Huang Yue, and Ma Dexin. Some other masterpieces you are going to explore, and I'm sure you will appreciate. Let's go.Hey, Katie.
Hi.
I'm really happy to visit you today and be surrounded by all this wonderful artwork. It's terrific. May I start with some of your international artists,
John Young.
John Young.
He's born in Hong Kong, but is very famous in Australia. Yes. As a painter.
Jessica.
And Jessica Zoob, who's a British artist who makes wonderful landscapes and abstract style, very emotional. And Maya Hewitt, also from England, and with a Filipina descent, beautiful artist. Mm-hmm. You can see there's many aspects from Hong Kong that she puts into her work. So this series she actually developed while she was in Hong Kong.
And more local artists. Like this couple.
So actually this is a mainland Chinese couple, Xiao Yinong and Mu Chen, and also from mainland China, Pan Jian, beautiful painter. He always paints forests. And then we also have another local artist. This whole wall is actually a salon style.
Right.
So we are showing so many different artists on this wall to give you a real flavor of what our 20 years of the gallery has been. So over here we have a painting by Julian Schnabel, the famous American painter, a Spanish artist, Marquez de Jadraque, with a small sculpture of a woman, and then a local artist who does these wonderful plaques, as you can see several of them throughout the exhibition, who's called Ko Siu Lan. She's from Hong Kong, but lives in Canada. We have another mainland Chinese artist, young artist called Yang Hao, who's a very exciting artist at the moment.
Yes, very popular as well.
And then our great master Huang Rei, which we have also several other works of his in the other room. And of course, Wong Keping, our sculptor that we've been showing for our 20 years. He was actually the first artist that we showed in the gallery. This artist over here, Hang Liu, also known as Liu Hong in China, she's actually the most famous American Chinese artist. Sadly, she passed away last summer, and she's just had a big exhibition at the Smithsonian honoring her life work in Washington, D.C.
好了，现在呢，我们来到这一个房呢，就是带着有三位新兴画会的领军人物啊，这里包括了黄月啦、王克平啦，还有马德兴，他们的作品呢，在最初期怎么去国外的时候受西方影响啊，或是他们在中国七十年尾、八十年初怎么酝酿他们的创作，在这里呢，你可以一览无遗。
So in this room, we have the three leaders of the early movement of Chinese contemporary art, called the Stars, from 1979. So we're showing Ma Dexiang, Huang Rei, and Wong Keping. So, and also some of the most important early works from these artists. It's really about the wood itself. So he really works to, you know, find the simplest form. So you'll see on his works, you don't have a nose or eyes, a mouth. So he's making this woman out of just the natural elements of the wood. So different sculptures, he's playing with the different shapes of the wood and the natural indentations and coloring of the wood. This one is called Three Lines. So he makes a woman in just three lines. And for him, it's like he discovered some masterpiece in doing just those three lines. So his challenge was met after so many years. He feels that since ancient times. So that's really how Wong Ka-ping is very
You can see intimate. How much he loves human bodies. And he's a very romantic man, right?
Yeah.
Explore a lot of different
comedian also. Yeah. Wong Ka-ping lives in Paris, and Huang Rei is in Beijing. He is still very active as an artist and a painter. Mm-hmm. He just made a very interesting exhibition to support the Ukraine.
Oh, 4 days after the war,
yes,
he made this painting.
And then the third artist that we're showing, who is the other star, who lives in Paris with mm-hmm. Wong Ka-ping, mm-hmm. and they're good friends, is Ma Dashong. Ma Dashong, and we have also his woodblock works from the early years. So those are also from the STARS exhibition, 1980, 1979, etc. So he's a wonderful painter. He's actually paralyzed from the waist down, so it's just amazing to see the work. This wonderful work by Ten Lin.
Why, he was in jail for 7 years.
He was in jail for seven
after
years.
After Wang Shan Shuji was put in the prison.
Yes, so she went the first time that she was elected president in the late 80s. Uh-huh. And then Ten Lin was at that time a student and then was part of the movement. And he was put in jail for 7 years. So we're very happy to show this work and also to bring awareness to what is happening in Myanmar, to support them. And most of Ten Lin's work is actually very Buddhist inspired. This is the Vietnamese artist Dinh Quy Le. Mm-hmm. So this is a very large piece of his. He doesn't usually make his photo weavings this large. Right. So this is a work about Cambodia. So you have a portrait of a young girl, and she's the portrait from the Tuol Sleng prison in Phnom Penh. Mm-hmm. And he's mixing it with the imagery of the Ramayana, which is the epic poem of Cambodia. It's called Rayam Kher. And so he's mixing it with these images and sort of drawing on the fact that the war and everything that happened in these countries is not the identity of the people of these countries. So such a rich history and culture mm-hmm. that, you know, is part of the whole journey of all these people. But many times Western tourists and people from the region, they just assume only things about the war. And this is a wonderful artist from Cambodia, and this is made from pencil shavings. Yeah. So I suggest he goes close up to it later. So so every piece is made from the shaving of a pencil.
Yeah.
This is a wonderful Vietnamese artist called Boy Kong Khan. He does these contemporary ceramic works where he actually paints contemporary imagery on them. It's very difficult to have a vase made in this size, so he doesn't even want to make them anymore because it's the risk of breaking. But this is one of his works from our last exhibition. So this is another Vietnamese artist, Tuan Andrew Nguyen, and he is commenting on the rhino horn trade in Vietnam. So this is a cast of the last rhino that existed in Vietnam. Mm-hmm. And he's assimilated it with the mythology of the dragon, where the dragon and the mythology of what rhino horn does to you is really about some kind of belief or superstition. Mm-hmm. So the rhinos are becoming extinct because of this belief that it makes you more powerful, but it's just a superstition. So he's mixing this idea of the ancient mythologies.
我就發現了九龍皇帝有一張攝影師記錄下來的作品嘅。
Yes. So it's a photograph by Serge Clément, who's taken the image of one of the artworks of the King of Kowloon. And we have next to it the old photographs of Hong Kong mm-hmm. by John Thompson. So those are from, you know, more than 120 years ago, 130, 40 years ago. And then this is a more recent photograph of also Hong Kong.
Katie 咧，頭先我同我哋介紹咗，就話咧，依個係 John Thompson 嘅好開始嘅攝影嚟嘅，就係 相機製造150、140年前，佢哋已經開始有影低咗、記錄咗香港嘅一啲生活啊、建築咁樣。
So as you can see, we have this beautiful landscape of Hong Kong by Shugro Ray, who's a artist who now lives in New York, and he does the pinhole camera imagery right onto the photographic paper.
Right.
So you can see, you don't see any boats moving in the sea because the exposure is so long that it just disappears.
Now this is Adidodia, a really interesting installation.
So Atul Dodia is one of the most important artists from India, most well known as well. He did this series of work for the Tate Museum in the year 2000 for a show that they had called Century City. And he had first done his shutter doors for that exhibition, and then he has continued. So there's not so many of his shutter doors, so we're very honored to have one piece in the exhibition. The great female artist Xiao Lu, who's also a performance artist, and she had done these 15 photographs, which we're only showing three of the 15, where she shot her works. And it had it related to the work that she did in 1989 in China at the China Avant-Garde exhibition, where she shot her work in the museum in Beijing. And so she made this work 15 years later. And it's about that story of her work.
Now we are in this corner with all Four Kings artwork. Remember, he was in
Venice Biennale.
We presented Hong Kong.
Yes, 2011.
So popular, those artwork, and I heard a lot of feedback.
Absolutely. So here we're showing like some of his very early work from 1976, and also more recent work. So, I mean, of course, it's so much we can show of Frog King because he's such a diverse artist. But we tried to show a few different things, something from the 90s, something from the 70s, something from, you know, more recently. And even, which is really wonderful, are these towers of toilet paper ink paintings. So he's such a diverse artist, constantly working. For me, he's the most important artist of Hong Kong.
He uses so many different materials to do his creation. First conceptual artist in Hong Kong.
Yes.
It's part of our
Absolutely.
History here. So remember the most famous good performance art in Beijing, 1995, where you can find Zheng Huan, Zhang Xing, Ma Liu Ming, they are really well-known artists. Represented the time as the masters in China. Wow, Katie!
So this is my favorite part of the exhibition, which is the memory of 20 years.
Yeah.
So even I have my first invitation card, and you were here for this exhibition,
yeah.
And Ma Dashong, Wong Kaping, everybody, all my friends, Michael Sullivan from Oxford University, my baby who was born, all the wonderful exhibitions and crazy things that we did during those exhibitions.
Oh, David Tang.
David yeah. Tang, Julian Schnabel. And we did a big exhibition for Julian Schnabel. Did a show with Baz Luhrmann, performance with Li Wei, where he's covered in mirror shards.
How great is that? Your clients, your artists become your lifetime friends, right?
Even Huang Rei with Paris Hilton when she was in town. Here's a wonderful performance by Li Wei at the before it was Art Basel Hong Kong. It was Art HK. So we covered him in mirrors. We can see here that he's being glued with the mirror shards.
Wow.
And he did a performance at the convention center that was just amazing. So, and the idea was, is that he wanted people to find their family photos. So in the exhibition, people picked up a photo and gave it to the archivist. And the archivist would scan the photo and put it on a website. And families found their own family photos, looking at it from all over the world. It was called Eurasia. Oh, I think that this is a great one. We did with Xiao Lu a performance. She was very moved by the Hong Kong protests. Mm-hmm. So she made this artwork performance as a reaction to the Hong Kong protests. And a performance artwork that she had done in front of the gallery where she was in a pyramid and we filled it up with red liquid and then she was glued inside and had to fight to get out to breathe.
Oh, okay.
It was very suffocating.
Oh, 我们很开心了，终于了就看到很完整的一个20周年的展览。 Katie.
So really in the future, we just feel like we're beginning. We haven't even started to do all that we'd like to do. So much more to do, to discover, to share, to promote, to offer to the world as far as art goes. So we just, you know, want to go bigger and stronger.
Right, congratulations.
Thank you.
Happy 20 years anniversary.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.